Ang laban mo ay laban namin. Laban nating lahat to. To defeat this health issue which is COVID-19 or coronavirus. Alright, so guys, anyways guys, maayong adlaw kaninyong tanan, ilabi na dira sa dakbayan sa Davao o sa tibuok kalibutan. Alright, so guys, our president there in Philippines are being thankful to those months of importance. When we speak about months of importance, guys, this is an allied group or allied people who help a lot in our countries. First, we have Philippine National Police or PNP, Armed Forces of the Philippines or AFP, Department of Labor and Local Government or DILG, Department of Health or DOH, Department of National Defense or DND, to take this action, guys. Or what I mean is NAP, National Action Plan, with this, with regard of this issue, COVID-19. Alright, so guys, ipapakita ko sa iyo yung video na to. It's all about the address of our Mr. President there in Philippines about the COVID-19 or the coronavirus. Sobrang nakaka-touch talaga, guys. So, panoorin nyo to, guys.
It has been a week since we called for a community quarantine and in its enhanced form in Metro Manila and various parts of Luzon. We in government continue to respond to the public needs, mobilize resources, and oversee developments. We are also addressing the COVID-19 pandemic challenges confronting our nation. First, let me reiterate my sincerest gratitude to all our courageous frontliners in this war, especially our healthcare workers, our doctors, nurses, medical technologists, and all other allied health professionals. Maraming salamat. Asahan niyo ang suporta ng inyong gobyerno. I am saddened by the news that the virus has claimed the lives of our doctors along the way. Lahat po sila ay bayani. And not only that, talagang bumilib ako. Bihira akong sumasaludo ng tao. Pero pa yung mga doktor natin, mga health workers na disgrasya, talagang saludo ako sa inyo. To the Filipino people, rest assured that your entire government is working hand in hand to safeguard your health, safety, and well-being in the face of threat posed by COVID-19. We will address all the different issues brought about by this pandemic, as well as ensure the protection of all our people, especially those who are serving in the front lines. Supplies of food, water, and other essentials will be provided to you throughout this ordeal. Financial assistance will also be extended, especially to those in the margins and the vulnerable groups. Halos lahat ho makatanggap. I also call on relevant agencies to ensure the speedy delivery of basic medical supplies and equipments to health facilities. From the approval, importation, and the delivery, everything must go smoothly to make sure that we do not waste time. Ay, alam mo, isang bagay talaga na alam ng lahat is itong padilidali, patamantamaran. Kailangan pagpasok ng papel, process mo kagad. Ilinya mo yung, you line up the tables where the papers should go, one after the other. Para madali, cut red tapes. I do not want red tapes. I do not want so many questions. Pagka sinertify ng isang government employee, I said, do not commit the mistake and we will all be happy and comfortable. Huwag ninyong, kung gusto ninyo magluko, huwag ninyo itong panahon na ito. To my fellow public servants, let us set aside our differences and work in solidarity to overcome this pandemic. We only have one common enemy, and that is COVID-19. Our transparency, integrity, accountability, and responsiveness are needed, and I expect all of you to exercise all these in safeguarding our fellow Filipinos. As President, I assure the public that the government will be on top of this situation at all times. We will not leave anyone behind. Sabay-sabay natin labanan ang COVID-19 para sa kabutihan ng lahat. I ask the entire country for your patience, understanding, and utmost cooperation. With your support, I am confident that we will emerge triumphant. Nothing is more formidable and resilient than the Filipino spirit. Matindi ang kalaban, but we will not surrender. Hindi tayo susuko, tayo ay lalaban. Yes, things will not be easy. And we Filipinos are tough. Mas malakas ang Pilipino sa anumang hamon.
Okay, so about the relief goods, yes, ginagawa lahat ng ating Pangulo. We have our barangay officials, our government officials, and as well as our parok leaders to really distribute that goods for us, guys. Kay, oh my God, nagpait na dyan ang kalibutan tungod ani nga health issue, which is COVID-19. Alright, so with regards to mga health worker guys, especially doctors and nurses, our president called them as our heroes. Bayani talaga sila guys. So, well in fact, sila yung unang mahahawaan guys if their patient have a positive of this one coronavirus. So, wala na tayong magagawa dyan guys. Hindi gusto ng ating mahal na Pangulo kung bakit sila namatay. Isa sa mga namatay is yung mag-asawang doktor sa Cebu guys. Because na positive din sila sa coronavirus. So, ipagpaasa na lang natin sa poong may kapal to guys. Okay? Nang dahil sa issue na ito guys, ang dami-dami mga negatibong comments ng sa ating administrasyon, especially to our President Rodrigo Rua Duterte. Pero the Mr. President kaliwalihadan na stayib. Basta mawala na siya guys. So ngayon guys, ipapakita ko sa iyo yung mga konting mga reklamo lang, mga comments nila about sa ating administrasyon. Panoorin niyo to guys. Wow, yung mga comment na, oh my gosh, dali, suntukan. Kita, tayo na lang magsuntukan. Huwag niyong anuhin yung presidente. Grabe kung makareklamo, kung makareact, wagas. ETCHUZZ HALEERR. Huwag naman kayo yung mga, guys, ito lang ha, yung mga nagre-reklamo, yung mga panay-reklamo, sila yung mga walang binatbat, walang ginagawa sa ating bansa. Dagdag lang kayo sa problema ng ating bansa na kinakaharap ngayon. Lalong-lalo na sa ating mahal na Pangulo. Kaya, stop. Better shout out, zipper your mouth, okay? Yung presidente natin is from Davao. So, affected lang talaga ako guys dahil sa mga nangyari ngayon. Dahil sa nangyari na health issue sa ating bansa. Hindi naman kagagawa ng ating mahal na Pangulo guys ang nangyari. Kumbaga guys, ito lang ha. Coronavirus is the biggest issue and problem that our country facing nowadays. Not only country in Philippines, but worldwide, guys, all over the world. At this time around, guys, pwede ba stop making, instead of making arguments that leads into a nonsense outcome, nothing will happen, guys. Please listen carefully about the last speech of our Mr. President, okay? Ito yung address niya, guys, for all Filipinos out there in Philippines.
Gagawin namin ang lahat. Hindi namin kayo pababayan. I now call on every Filipino to participate in this war by following the guidelines and set the national government and your local officials. Nothing is more important than your cooperation. I repeat, stay home, huwag matigas ang ulo. The outcome of this war depends largely on you as well. I look forward to the day that we, the Filipinos, can finally claim victory of this war and emerge as stronger and more united Filipinos and Philippines. Maraming salamat po. Osbo nako. Ayaw mo kahadlok. Tagalogin ko, huwag kayong matakot. Nandito yung gobyerno ninyo para kayo pagsilbihan. At totoong pagsilbihan. Salamat.
Oh, alright. So, guys, just simple instruction only, okay? Stay at home. Huwag matigas ang ulo. Okay? Isang bala kayo sa akin. ETCHUZZ HALEERR, guys. So, muna siya, guys. So, guys, please cooperate. Our participation and cooperation is the biggest, the most important all over, guys, especially there in Philippines. Kana lang, guys, ang gipangayo, kung dili taggahig mga ulo, guys, wala unta, wala jud unta. And one word to say, guys, is we have to pray. Prayer is the most, what do you call this one, is the best armor, the best thing that we can do is to have our prayer. Prayer is powerful. So, thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. To God be the glory. God bless everyone. And be safe. Just stay at home, okay? All right. So, that's all. And thank you once again. Babush, guys.
I don't know why I wanna make it even harder. But I'm not the kind of man to take the easy road.